Alright, let's go old school, man. Bust out the West Virginia. War Games is running a really cool promo right now, a Life Ring, they call it. It's a package that you can buy in the premium shop. You're basically buying the West Virginia. However, pretty much all the proceeds go to a suicide prevention program for veterans. So you really can't say no to that. I think this package is like 30 bucks, and they run other one. They run one other one. I think it's like 12 bucks or something like that. And again, that gets you a couple missions, some flags and whatnot, but all the proceeds go to suicide prevention with that. So how can you say no to that? It's the right thing to do. If you're going to spend a certain amount of dollars per week on this game, whether it be in doubloons or another ship or something, this is one of those things where it's absolutely justified. Looks like we got a pretty good lineup here too. One other West Virginia, New Mexico, but a lot of tier 5 battleships too, so we'll see what we can do. I'm not a big fan of Epicenter, but we're gonna see what we can make happen. What we got on this side of Frederick, Hawkins. I'd rather be on the other side of the map, but I'm gonna kind of favor the right side just to give a little bit of BB support to them. They got a Congo and a Texas on the other side, so we got some pretty good cruiser support. So I'm gonna move up a little bit, see what happens. Wanna be an AP. I just got a new laptop, so I had to reinstall the game. And whenever you do that, it's like it brings all your settings back to like a default new. So you, whenever you play a different ship, you got to go through and reset pretty much anything you want. Your AA, I like running these rings too right here. Your AA range, your secondary range. I don't really consider the West Virginia to be a secondary ship, but it at least it lets you know where you stand. See what kind of range I get with a spotter. Yeah, he's within range. I haven't played this ship much. I think I only played one other game in it, so it's gonna take me a little bit to kind of figure out the guns and the range. It's gonna be a little bit of trial and error, but we'll see what we can make happen here. Yeah, he's stopping behind that island. Oh, he just got wrecked. I'm gonna light him up here too shortly. His engine's out. I doubt he's using last stand in that ship. Alright, we'll get what we can on him. Oh, he's already dead. Alright. 6 of 1, half dozen of the other. I gotta watch this DD on the other side of the island. Yeah, the other West Virginia's kinda opening up a little bit. 21 knots, so I gotta watch that lower hash mark on my crosshair. I like this NG crosshair too. Oh, give him that, see what happens. He just come out of a turn too, so he's gonna be a little slow. Yeah, it's gonna fall on him nice. Yep, right where I want it. Cool. 10K, I'll take that. I'll take that all day long. Wow, he's just getting lit up. Cool, let's keep it up, man. Oh, he's gonna turn out too. Come on, 7 seconds. I held a little high on him. I think he's gonna continue to turn. Doesn't look like he's gonna though, so I might overpen. Yeah. I thought he was gonna commit to his turn. That's all right, we'll give him another dose. Wow, he's gonna, that ship's going down quick. Now he's turning out. Oh. That's cool, I'll take it, but they're dying too quick. Where else can I shoot at? Gotta watch out for tourists, because I can almost guarantee you they're coming. No hits, holy shit. I have a lot of ships that are broadside here to me soon if I get my guns around. Come on, guns. Breathing island. Oh, he's so perfect. See him. That's when he realized he fucked up. All right, what else we got? All right, we'll come back in. I want to kind of stay in the center here. He's not giving me the best angle, but I can fire on him. Yeah, they're gonna lose that cruiser. Good. Yeah, we're pretty much steamrolling this game. This rock's pretty much right in the way. I'll take the cap though. I fired that Congo. I don't have anything else to shoot at right now, so he's kind of angling away from me pretty hard, but hold behind him a little bit because I think he's going to commit. Yep, he is. All right, we'll get whatever damage we can off him. Got whatever we could. This rock is like right in the way. I'll kill that DD if I gotta. Nope, somebody else did. Alright. Wow, this is a complete blowout, man. And Iron Duke's turning out. Those look good. Whatever. Yeah, we'll get another round on him. Whoever gets me the best target is going to get lit up. I don't have many ships I can shoot at. Oh, I probably at Kong. Definitely that Kong if I get my guns around. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. I don't know if I let him enough, but no, that looks good. That looks real good. We just slayed this game, man. That Congo is gonna go down. Somebody will kill him by the time I round this rock. I'm sorry, dead is dead. We won. Complete steamroll. Yeah, the West Virginia is fun. Back to the Iron Duke. Oh, that's gonna miss. He turned away. He's turning away. Maybe not. I held high on him. Fragged at him. Alright, we won. I don't care.
I hate my work, but I'm in.
Yeah, sometimes it's fun to go back to those lower tiers, man. I'll take it. It's kind of where you all started. You know what I mean? It's where everybody kind of came from in the beginning. So whenever I go back to those lower tiers, I feel like the pressure's off from what it is whenever you play tier 10. And right now, I think there's just so much wrong with tier 10 with all these HE spamming high rate of fire ships and these concept ships. It's just, it's not even enjoyable. I'd rather play tier 8 and tier 9 all day long. But this is fun. The West Virginia is a really good ship at tier 6. Guns are pretty sick. I think they're 406s. Yeah. And if you buy this ship right now, you're really supporting a good cause. So you can go out, have a good time, low pressure, help out a veteran, hopefully, and just have a good time playing some ships, man. So it's a good time.